In this video, we will demonstrate how to check the KEB F6 elevator drive's input and output circuits, also known as a diode check. If it's suspected that one of the drive's power stage components has failed, these tests can help confirm this. First, disconnect power to the drive and lock out the main supply and allow the DC bus to discharge. Then, remove all wiring from the terminals. Use a multimeter with diode checking functionality and select it to take voltage drop measurements. When making the measurements, ensure that good contact is being made between the meter leads and the metal portion of the terminals for a steady, accurate reading. For this example, we are using an F6 housing 4 drive to do this diode check. Now let's begin by checking the input rectifiers. The input rectifier terminals are identified with the labels L1, L2, and L3. We'll begin by measuring the positive side of the input rectifiers. We'll put the negative black lead on the positive plus DC bus terminal and the positive red lead on the L1 rectifier terminal. The measured voltage drop should be between 0.4 and 0.5 volts. Measure the voltage drops at the L2 and L3 terminals. These should both read OL or open on the multimeter. Note that with the housing 2 F6 drives, the measured voltage drops will be between 0.4 and 0.5 volts on the L1, L2, and L3 terminals. Next, we'll check the negative side of the input rectifiers. Reverse the meter leads and put the positive red lead on the negative DC bus terminal. Put the negative black lead on the L1 terminal and measure the voltage drop at the L2 and L3 terminals. All three terminals should be between 0.3 and 0.5 volts. Note the exception that with the housing 2 F6 drives, the measured voltage drops will be between 0.4 and 0.5 volts on the L1, L2, and L3 terminals. If any of the measurements show a reading of 0 volts, this would indicate a short circuit. If the voltage measurements show a reading lower or much higher than the expected values, this would indicate a failure. Next, we'll move into checking the braking transistor. Keeping your multimeter on the diode checking functionality, we'll continue to take voltage drop measurements. The braking transistor is connected to the external braking resistor at the terminal labeled R. Measure the positive side of the braking transistor by putting the negative black lead on the positive or plus DC bus terminal and the red lead on the R terminal. On all housings of the F6 drives, the measured voltage drop should be approximately 0.3 to 0.4 volts. Next, check the negative side of the braking transistor. Put the positive red lead on the negative DC bus terminal. Put the negative black lead on the R terminal. For housing 2 drives, this measurement should read OL or open. For housing 3 and 4 drives, the voltage drop should measure approximately 1.58 volts. And for housing 6 through 9 drives, the measured voltage drop should be approximately 0.3 to 0.4 volts. If any of the measurements show a reading of 0 volts, this would indicate a short circuit. If the voltage measurements show a reading much lower or higher than expected values, this would indicate a failure. Finally, we will check the IGBT output transistors. The IGBT output terminals are identified with the labels U, V, and W. First, measure the positive side of the IGBTs. Put the negative black lead on the positive DC bus terminal and the positive red lead on the U, V, and W phase terminals. On all housings of the F6 drives, the measured voltage drop should be approximately 0.3 to 0.4 volts. Next, check the negative side of the IGBTs. Reverse the meter leads and put the positive red lead on the negative DC bus terminal. Then put the negative black lead on the U, V, and W phase terminals. On all housings of the F6 drives, the measured voltage drop should be approximately 0.3 to 0.4 volts. If any of the measurements show a reading of 0 volts, this would indicate a short circuit. If the voltage measurements show a reading much lower or higher than expected values, this would indicate a failure. It is important to note that in some cases, a component failure will not necessarily be detected by a voltage drop measurement. For example, a blown IGBT can still measure a proper voltage drop. In cases like this, you would have to rely on other indicators like a blown mainline fuse or drive errors associated with component failure. An example would be an E.OC overcurrent error, which would indicate a shorted IGBT. For further troubleshooting and repair assistance, contact your controller manufacturer or KEB America.